Your brain uses specialized neurons known as grid cells to keep track of your location. Every brain has thousands and thousands of these cells. We call them grid cells because if you were able to look at just one of them while you were walking around, the places where it fired would make a triangular grid. Every time you're at one of the locations on the grid, the exact same grid cell fires. Whether you're at this spot or that spot, the brain gets the same signal from the same grid cell. So how can your brain tell the difference between different locations on the grid? Since there are thousands and thousands of these grid cells in your brain, there are thousands and thousands of these invisible mental grids. Remember, each grid cell represents one entire grid. And importantly, the grids are of different sizes and orientations and are stacked on top of one another. If you have multiple cells with grids of different sizes firing at once, it's possible to narrow down your location by comparing all of the different grids. The place where all of the grids overlap is where you are. But how exactly does the brain keep track of all of these grid cells that are firing at once? Our idea was that the grid cells are essentially forming a number system, like how computers use binary or we use decimal numbers. This could be done if the scales of the grids were organized in a particular way. For example, if you wanted to know where you were on an 8-meter line with 1-meter accuracy, you might assign a cell to keep track of each meter mark. But if you asked a computer scientist to do it, they wouldn't do it that way at all. It's very inefficient. They would divide the line in half and assign one cell to the left half and one cell to the right half. Then you successively subdivide in halves again and again. That's essentially a binary code. You only save 2 cells in this 8-meter example, but as your number line gets longer and longer, the efficiency increases substantially. The idea here is that evolution would drive the brain to code the most information using the least number of cells. It turns out that this is achieved not by having a binary code or a decimal code, but a code based on Euler's number, e. Like pi, e is a transcendental number, meaning it has decimal places that trail off into infinity. It's also found everywhere in nature as the basis for logarithms, exponential functions, and normal distributions, also known as bell curves. We theoretically derived that the sizes of the grids should scale up in e-based ratios, specifically the square root of e when it comes to two-dimensional maps. Looking at actual grid cells from experiments done in rats, our predictions were well supported by the data. There are clusters of cells that represent grids which are successively square root of e, larger than one another, just like the digits in the tens place of decimal numbers are 10 times bigger than the digits in the ones place.
We calculated that an animal like a rat would need about 10 such grid cell digits to represent a specific location in a given two-dimensional mental map of its natural behavioral range, sort of like a GPS coordinate. We were also working with other researchers to see how this number system works in 3D. We think bats, for example, will have similar kinds of scaling grid, but because they have to deal with an extra dimension, the ratio between the sides will be close to the cube root of e instead of square root of e.